The PC 1.0 release of PlayerUnknown's Battlegrounds made great changes to the game's ballistics. All guns are set apart from each other thanks to individual weapon class modifiers. They also added hit area damage modifiers on top of this so that each specific part of the body will take different amount of damage. The new formula for damage calculation is now way more complex than ever before. Because of this, we will revisit our favorite weapons and we will check out how the PC 1.0 release has changed them. Today, we're going to take a look at all assault rifles and we will compare them side by side. I will show you all the important stats and values to help you pick the right assault rifle for every situation. Later, I will make an individual updated weapons guide, covering each assault rifle in greater detail. First, we will have to discuss the new damage modifiers, namely the weapon class damage and the hit area damage. All assault rifles have a weapon class damage modifier of 230% for damage to the head, 100% for damage to the torso, and 90% for damage to the limbs. Thanks to the hit area modifier, the damage will not be the same throughout the entire torso. While shots to the belly button area deal 90% of damage, shots to the collarbone and everywhere else in the abdomen will deal 100% of damage. Naturally, shots to the chest will deal more damage at 110%. The limbs and even the head also have their own values. The biceps and thighs take 60% of damage. Forearms and shins take 50%. Hands and feet take the least amount of damage at 30%. The values for damage to the limbs might be very low, but they do not get reduced when a player wears armor because vests can only protect the torso. The head might have a constant value of 100% of hit area damage, but the neck only takes 75%. This is important to take note because helmets in the game now protect the neck as well. Nice. All of these values will play a huge part when we compare the guns. We will first start comparing these guns in terms of raw damage output. The good news is that the assault rifles that fire the same bullets also deal the same damage per shot. The ARC-A3, the M16A4, the M416 and the SCAR-L all fire 5.56mm rounds and are rated at 44 damage. Just for info, this number was brought up from 41 to 44, so they deal more damage now. Without armor, shooting at the belly button area will deal 41.8 damage. The abdomen and the collarbone areas will take 44, while the chest will take 48.4. It will take 3 body shots to kill an unarmored target with any of these guns. With level 3 armor on, you will generally need 6 body shots to make a kill. The exception for this is if you always hit the chest, because then you will only need 5. Shooting at an unprotected head will deal 101.2 damage for a one-shot kill. But you will need an extra shot if you hit the neck as it only takes 75.9 damage. With a level 3 helmet on, both the neck and the head of your target will take 3 shots before he dies. The biceps and the thigh areas take 23.8 damage and they need 5 shots for a kill. The forearms and shins take 19.8, so they need 6 shots, and finally the hands will take 11.9 damage, so they will need 9 shots for a kill. This is a lot of info and we're just getting started. Try to remember the key points and know that you should always try to aim for the head or the upper torso. The Groza and the AKM both have a damage rating of 49. These 7.62 assault rifles used to be rated at 48 damage points, so they were buffed up slightly when the game was fully released. An unarmored target will take 46.5 damage to the belly button area. The abdomen and the collarbone takes 49 damage, while the chest takes away more than half of a health bar from an enemy because that area takes 53.9 damage. Aim for an unprotected chest with these guns and you will only need 2 shots to kill. If you're facing a level 3 armored target, then you will need 5 body shots for a kill. Without the helmet, one headshot will deal 112.7 damage and it will instantly kill your enemy. A neck shot needs only 1 extra bullet because it deals 84.5, and with a level 3 helmet on your enemy, you will have to make sure that you land an extra shot to make the kill. The bicep and thigh areas take 26.5 damage and they will need 4 shots to kill. The forearm and shin areas take 22.1, so they need 5, and the hands and feet take 13.2, so those will need 8 shots to kill. So far, we've talked about the damage for an individual shot. But that's not the only criteria that determines how powerful a weapon truly is. We also have to take into account the rate of fire, which refers to how fast a gun can spit out bullets. Now, we have to talk about these guns individually, because they don't all deal the same damage per second. To measure DPS, we will assume that all the shots hit the target in the same part of the body. The ARC-A3 shares the same DPS with the M416 because they both have the same rate of fire at 0.08 seconds per shot or around 11 shots per second. This is a slight increase from their previous rate of fire of 0.09 seconds. Since they both had the same damage rating of 44, they will both deal 513 damage per second. You might think that these guns are equal in damage, but they're not. The RK3 needs 3.67 seconds for a reload, while the M416 only needs 2.1. Taking this into account, and assuming that the guns don't have an extended magazine attached, it will give us the sustained damage per second, or just SDPS for short. This is where the ARC-A3 falls short with the 212 SDPS, while the M416 beats it with 283. Looking at the SCAR-L, things don't seem to be looking very good for this one. It has the slowest rate of fire of all the 5.56mm assault rifles, at 0.096 seconds per shot. And it used to be 0.1 when it first came out. Nowadays, this gun can shoot about 10 shots per second. That's why the SCAR-L can only deal 458 DPS. Luckily for the SCAR-L, it only takes 2.2 seconds for a reload, allowing it to deal 260 SDPS. The M16A4 seems to be a great weapon when it comes to damage over time. With its rate of fire of 0.075 seconds per shot, or at least 13 shots per second, the gun boasts a DPS rating of 587. Its fire rate used to be at 0.08 seconds per shot, so it definitely got a buff. It also reloads quickly at 2.2 seconds, resulting in an SDPS of 297. The only catch is that this gun cannot fire in full auto. While the delay between bursts is the same value as the delay between shots, you will have to keep tapping the weapon to enjoy the fastest rate of fire among all assault rifles. The AKM might have joined the Groza in boasting the highest single shot damage, but it fires very slowly at 0.1 seconds per shot, shooting about 10 bullets per second. The AKM is rated at 490 DPS. If we limit these guns to just one magazine, then the AKM can outdamage the SCAR-L over time. The bad news is that the AKM takes 2.9 seconds to finish reloading. This makes the SDPS value lower than the SCAR-L at 249. The Groza has better damage over time stats than its fellow care package exclusive, the ARC-A3. Not only does it share a high damage rating with the AKM, but its rate of fire clocks in at 0.08 seconds per shot, being able to shoot about 12 shots per second, and it will allow it to deal 613 damage in the same period of time, scoring higher than the M16A4. Unfortunately, it does need 3 seconds to reload, so an SDPS of 272 is not better than the M16A4's SDPS of 297. If you've already decided that the M16A4 or the Groza are the best guns in the game, then don't. All of these assault rifles have their own spread ratings, so some of these guns are harder to control than others. The higher the spread rating, the more you will have to pull down your mouse as you fire, so that you can keep hitting your target. And that is not the only stat that will affect your aim though. The range stat of a gun determines how far a target can be before your shots become ineffective. A higher range stat means that you can effectively shoot at targets from greater distances. The bullet speed rating will determine how fast your bullet will fly. The slower the bullet speed, the more that you will have to lead your target. And then, there is the biggest mystery in Battlegrounds, the damage drop. If you are trying to make a long range kill, then your bullet will now lose damage over time. This means that your bullet that cost 44 damage points will no longer do that when it hits a target standing at about 500 meters away from you. Unfortunately, nobody knows exactly how much this damage drop-off is. Some guys give examples using real-world calculations, but nobody knows for sure. So for now, until we have figured out a way to show you the actual damage drop, we will leave it out of the equation. Just remember that it exists and that it will affect you. When we speak about recoil, then I'm sure that the AKM comes in mind. This gun shares its spread rating with the Groza at 0.15. Both of these guns have a significant upward kick, so be ready to bring your mouse down as soon as you pull the trigger, but you knew that already. Neither of these guns can attach foregrips or stocks, so you will always be dealing with the recoil in full force. They also share the same bullet speed with 715 meters per second, and they have the same range rating of 380. Not only do you have to deal with a strong recoil, but you will also have to lead your target a lot more compared to some of the other guns. The SCAR-L and the ARC-A3 both have the same spread rating of 0.08 and a 350 meter range rating. The difference is that the ARC-A3 has the fastest initial bullet speed among all assault rifles with 940 meters per second. The SCAR-L has the lowest bullet speed of all the 5.56 ARs at 870. But it is still way easier to lead your targets with the SCAR-L than with the AKM. If you get used to firing the SCAR-L, then you will also find it similarly easy to use an unmodified M416. It has a spread rating of 0.08 like the SCAR-L, but the M416 is just slightly better at longer distances. It has a range rating of 360 meters and it has an initial bullet speed of 880. So you will have a slightly easier time making long range shots with this gun. The stock gives the M416 the edge. The additional recoil reduction makes it more solid and well rounded compared to the SCAR-L. The M16A4 looks like it can hold its own at long range. It has a spread rating of 0.1, a range rating of 400, and its shots travel at 900 meters per second. Putting care package guns aside, it has the fastest bullet speed of all assault rifles. The problem is that it's hard to enjoy these capabilities when you aren't able to use an 8x scope. If you really must use this gun at ultra long ranges, then you'll have to make use of the 4x scope. These were all the major changes that came with the PC 1.0 release and with the further updates. I will prepare an in-depth video about each assault rifle with all the new changes and with some tips and tricks on how to use each weapon. So make sure that you keep an eye on the channel so that you are the first to know. Or even better yet, make sure to subscribe and you will always be the first to know. This was Fog of Gaming, thanks for watching, and I will see you in Battlegrounds.